Shabbat Shalom. I'm Rabbah Arlene Berger, and I'm very happy to be celebrating Shabbat with you this evening. We'll begin with some praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Kol hanshama tehallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Kol hanshama tehallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And we'll now turn to Shalom Aleichem as we welcome the Shabbat angels. Shalom Aleichem, Malachei Hasharet, Malachei Elyon. Mi Melech Malchei Hamlachim HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Boachem L'Shalom, Malachei HaShalom, Malachei Elyon. Mi melech malchei hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu. Baruchuni leshalom malachei hashalom malachei elyon. Mi melech malchei hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu. Tzeitchem leshalom malachei hashalom Malachei Elyon. Mi melech malchei hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu. Return to Lachadodi as we welcome the Shabbat Queen. And we'll do the first two verses and the last two verses. Lecha dodi likrat kala penei Shabbat nekabela. Lecha dodi likrat kala penei Shabbat nekabela. Shamor v'zachor v'dibur echad. Hishmianu el hamyuchad. Adonai echad ushmo echad. L'shemo tiferet v'lit hila lecha dodi likrat kala p'nei Shabbat nekabela likrat Shabbat lechu v'nelcha ki hi mekor ha'bracha merosh mikadem nesucha sof ma'ase b'machshava techila lecha dodi likrat kala p'nei Shabbat nekabela yamin usmol tifrotzi v'et Adonai ta'aritzi al yad ish ben parzi v'nismecha v'nagila Lecha dodi likrat kala, p'nei Shabbat nekabela. Boi b'shalom ateret ba'ala, gam b'simcha uv'tzohola, toch emunei am segula. Boi chala, boi chala, lecha dodi likrat kala. P'nei Shabbat nekabela. We now turn to the Baruch Hu. So we've been setting ourselves up, right? We sang some praise. We welcomed the Shabbat angels. We welcomed the Sabbath Queen, which consolidated for us our relationship between us and Israel. And well, between us as Israel and God. And now we'll do our call to prayer, which only can be done in community, the Baruch Hu. Baruch Hu et Adonai HaMevorach. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach. Leolam Va'ed. Praised are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, who speaks the evening into being, skillfully opens the gates, thoughtfully alters the time and changes the seasons, and arranges the stars in their heavenly courses according to plan. You are creator of day and night, rolling light away from darkness and darkness away from light, transforming day into night and distinguishing one from the other. Adonai Tzvaot is your name. Ever living God, may you reign continually over us into eternity. Baruch Ata Adonai HaMa'ariv Aravim. God loves us with an eternal love. Ahavat Olam. Ahavat Olam Beit Yisrael Amcha Ahavta. Torah u'mitzvot chukim u'mishpatim otanu limadeta. Al kein Adonai Eloheinu b'shochveinu v'kumeinu nasiach b'chukecha v'nismach b'divrei Toratecha u'v'mitzvotecha le'olam va'ed. Ki hem chayenu ve'orech yameinu ve'orech yameinu uvahem nege yomam v'laila v'ahavatecha al tasir mimenu le'olamim baruch ata Adonai ohev amo Yisrael. Shema. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Baruch Shem Kivod, Malchuto Leolam Va'ed. V'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha, v'chol levavcha, v'chol nafshecha, v'chol meodecha, v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele. Asher anochi mitzavecha hayom alevavecha v'shinantam levanecha v'dibarta bam v'shiftecha beveitecha uvlechtecha v'derech uv'shochbecha uv'kumecha uksatam le'ot al yadecha v'hayu letotafot b'neinecha uchtavtam al mezuzot beitecha uv'sharecha. Leman tizkeru vasitem et kol mitzvotai vitem kedoshim le'Elohechem. You shall love Adonai your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all that is yours. These words which I command you this day shall be taken to heart. Teach them diligently to your children. Speak of them when you sit in your home and when you walk on your way, when you lie down and when you rise up. Bind them as a sign upon your hand, and they shall be as a reminder above your eyes. Inscribe them on the doorposts of your home and upon your gates. Then you will remember and fulfill all my mitzvot and be holy before your God. I want to add a little personal note here, since this V'ahavta that I just read talks about teaching them diligently to your children. And I've received a few emails over the past month or so from people asking if my son and his wife had their daughter. Many of you remembered that before this pandemic hit and I was no longer able to come in, I would share stories about my daughter-in-law's pregnancy and the fact that I was excited to become a safta, a grandmother. So I just want to let you know that my granddaughter, Brianna May, turned 5 months this week. And Baruch Hashem, thank God, she's healthy and she's wonderful. And she's really been a ray of light in this time of not necessarily darkness, but murkiness perhaps. And I know that all of you who have children and who had been telling me about how wonderful it is to be a grandparent, I know now that you were all telling me the truth and you weren't exaggerating at all. So thank you so much for caring and asking. Shirat Hayam, the song at the sea. When God's children beheld the power of the divine, They sang in praise of God, gladly accepting God's sovereignty. Moses, Miriam, and the people Israel sang with great joy this song to you. Mi chamocha ba'elim Adonai, mi chamocha nedar ba'kodesh, nora tehilot oseh feleh. Who is like you, God, among all that is worshipped? Who is like you, majestic in holiness, awesome in splendor, working wonders? Your children beheld your sovereignty as you divided the sea before Moses. This is my God, they responded, declaring, Adonai imloch leolam va'ed. Hashkivenu. Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu l'shalom v'ha'amidenu malkeinu l'chaim. Help us, Adonai our God, to lie down in peace and awaken us to life again, our sovereign. Spread over us your shelter of peace. Guide us with your good counsel. Save us for the sake of your mercy. Shield us from enemies and pestilence, from starvation, sword, and sorrow. Remove evil forces that surround us. Shelter us in the shadow of your wings. You, O God, guard us and deliver us. You are a gracious and merciful God, ruler. Guard our coming and our going. Grant us life and peace now and always. Ufros aleinu sukat shlomecha, baruch ata Adonai, hapore sukat shalom aleinu, v'al kol amo Yisrael, v'al Yerushalayim. Spread over us your shelter of peace. Praised are you, Adonai, who spreads a shelter of peace over us, over all people Israel, and over Jerusalem. V'shamru. V'shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat. La'asot et ha-shabbat le'dorotam berit olam. Beni uven b'nei Yisrael, oti le'olam, oti le'olam, oti le'olam. V'shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat. La'asot et ha-shabbat le'dorotam berit olam. Ki sheshet yamim asa Adonai, et ha-shamayim ve'et ha-aretz v'shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat la'asot et ha-shabbat le'dorotam berit olam. U'vayom ha-shvi'i shavat v'yinafash, shavat v'yinafash. Shavat vayinafash v'shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat la'asot et ha-shabbat le'dorotam berit olam. We now turn to the Amidah. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu ve'Elohei avoteinu, Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzchak, ve'Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel, ve'Elohei Leah, Ha'el Hagadol, Hagibur ve'Hanora, El Elyon, Gomel Chasadim Tovim ve'Kone Hakol, ve'Zocher Chasdei Avot. Umevi goel ivne vneihem leman shemo bi'ahava. Melech ozer umoshia umagen. Baruch atah Adonai, magen Avraham v'ezrat Sarah. Atah gibor le'olam Adonai, mechayem etim atah rav lehoshia. Mechalkel chayim bechesed. Mechayim etim berachamim rabim, somech noflim berofei cholim, umatir asurim, umekayem emunato li shelei afar, michamocha ba'al gevurot, umido melech, melech memit umechaye, umatzmiach Yeshua. V'neman atah lehachayot metim, baruch atah Adonai, Mechaye ha-metim. We'll now have a few moments for some silent reflection, and we'll gather back together for Oseh Shalom. You are holy, and your name is holy, and holy ones praise you each day. Praised are you, Adonai, the holy God. Oseh shalom bimromav, u'yaseh shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'imru, imru, amen. Yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, yaseh shalom, yaseh shalom, shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael. May the one who brings peace on high bring peace on high, bring peace to us, to all Israel, and to all those who dwell on earth, and let us say amen. We now turn to a prayer for healing, and I invite everyone to take a moment and bring to mind and to heart the names of those who are in need of healing, family members, friends, caregivers, healers, those who are affected by COVID, all those who can use blessings of strength and blessings of healing. Mi sheberach avoteinu mekor habracha le'imoteinu. May the source of strength who blessed the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us say amen. Mi sheberach imoteinu mekor habracha la'avoteinu. Bless those in need of healing with refuah shelema, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say amen. It's now time for Kiddush, and if you have a Kiddush cup, a glass of wine, I invite you to raise it with me as we recite the Kiddush. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Borei Pri Hagafen. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher kichanu b'mitzvotav v'ratzavanu, v'shabbat kodesho b'ahava v'ratzon hinchilanu, zikaron lema'aseh v'reishit, ki hu yom techila lemikra'e kodesh, zecher letziat v'yitzrayim, kivanu v'charta, v'otanu kidashta, Mikol ha'amim v'shabbat kodshecha v'ahava uvratzon hinchaltanu. Baruch ata Adonai mekadesh ha'shabbat. It is now time for some Torah. And this week's Torah portion is Ki Tetzé. We're in the book of Deuteronomy still. And the Dvar Torah I'm going to share with you today is called When You Go Out to War, Remember Amalek and Don't Become Him. And it's written by a colleague of mine, Rabbi Saul Oreski. Some of you may know him. He's a spiritual leader of Mishkan Torah in Greenbelt. So this week's Torah portion, Ki Tetzé, is bookmarked by references to warfare. Its opening verse, Ki Tetzé la Melchama al Oyvecha, when you take the field against your enemies, goes on to dictate how a female captive whom the victorious soldier desires is to be treated. This treatment, while liberal for its time, is nevertheless barbaric by our standards, since the captive apparently has no say as to whether she wants to be married to the soldier. Ki Tetzé concludes with the following passage, Zachor et asher asa lecha Amalek v'derech v'tzeitchem mimitzrayim. Remember what Amalek did to you on your journey after you left Egypt, and commanding the annihilation of the Amalekites, sticks the landing with the words, Lo tishkach, don't forget. As if we could forget. The latter passage, which we also read as the maftir for the Shabbat preceding Purim, reminds us to blot out the memory of Amalek from under heaven. If this implies that we will always have enemies whom we must destroy, we hardly need the reminder. Amalek has come to symbolize all the enemies of the Jews throughout the ages. Haman of Purim, for instance, the quintessential Jew hater, is called an Agagite in Megillat Esther, Agag being the Amalekite king later executed in the book of Samuel in chapter 15 of 1 Samuel. Destroying our enemies has not historically been in our power, despite the carnage depicted in the book of Joshua and Megillat Esther. Thankfully, pursuing destruction generally has not been our chosen course, even when we've had the ability. Instead, more often than not, as a people, we have taken the path of peace, except when pushed to wage war, which the state of Israel, unfortunately, has frequently had to do. Yet the Torah reminds us that even in wartime, not all actions are permitted. Outright rape, sadly still a common method of war today, for instance, is forbidden. While the Israel Defense Force's ideal of Tohar HaNeshek, purity of arms, is cited more often in its breach than in its observance, it remains the IDF's official policy and is indeed its aspiration. Is it even possible to uphold such ideals when the playing field is so uneven, when they are not held or even acknowledged by all sides in a conflict, when barbarism and battle rules the day? It is possible, though difficult, and essential that we uphold these ideals, because the cost of not doing so is too high. A tiny fraction of that price is the loss of public admiration. Israel often sees itself as having long ago lost the battle for public approval anyway. The far greater toll on the individual, him or herself, because the real danger of immoral military behavior is that of becoming Amalek. What was Amalek's great sin, earning them forever the curse of promised genocide? It is that they attacked the stragglers, the powerless Israelites at the rear of the column, the aged and the infirm. It was a craven act of unspeakable cowardice. They did not fear God, as our portion claims. When we allow ourselves to take advantage of the powerless, how are we any better than Amalek? Perhaps the Torah is reminding us to not automatically take the nuclear option in conflicts of any sort, be they military or political. To not resort to the bludgeon when a gentle word could suffice. and to practice restraint, even when pressed. Remember Amalek and don't become him. Wise words. We now turn to Aleinu. Aleinu l'shabeach l'adon ha'kol atet gedula liotzer breshit shelo asanu kegoye ha'aratzot velo samanu k'mishpochot ha'adama shelo sam chalkenu kahem v'gor aleinu kechol hamonam v'anachnu korim u'mishtachavim u'modim lifnei melech malchei hamlachim ha'kadosh baruch hu שהוא נוטה שמיים ויוסד הארץ, ומושב יקרו בשמיים ממעל, ושכינתו זו, ושכינתו זו, וגובה מרומים, הוא אלוהינו אין עוד, אמת מלכנו אפס ולתו, קעקעתו בתורתו, וידעת היום, וידעת היום, והשבות אל לבבך, כי אדוני הוא האלוהים, בשמיים ממעל, ועל הארץ, ועל הארץ, מתחת, אין עוד, אין עוד. ככתוב בתורתך, אדוני ימלוך לעולם ועד, ונאמר, והיה אדוני למלך על כל הארץ. ביום ההוא, יהיה אדוני אחד, ושמו אחד. We are now in the month of Elul, which is the month before Tishrei, before the high holidays. The month of Elul is a time of reflection, a time to look inside ourselves, figure out where we've come from, where we're going. What have we done right this past year? Where have we missed the mark? How do we want to change? One of the traditions of the month of Elul is to read the Psalm of the Days of Awe. It is Psalm 27, and we read this at the end of both the Shachrit, the morning service, and Mariv, the evening service. So I'm going to read it now in the English. A Psalm of David. The Lord is my light and my help, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life, whom shall I dread? When evildoers draw near me to slander me, when foes threaten, they stumble and fall. Though armies be arrayed against me, I will have no fear. Though wars threaten, I remain steadfast in my faith. One thing I ask of the Lord, for this I yearn, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold God's beauty, to pray in God's sanctuary. God will hide me in God's shrine, safe from peril. God will shelter me beyond the reach of disaster. God will raise my head high above my enemies. I will bring God offerings with shouts of joy, singing and chanting praise to the Lord. O God, hear my voice when I call. Be gracious to me and answer. It is you that I seek, says my heart. It is your presence that I seek, O Lord. Hide not from me. Reject not your servant. You have always been my help. Do not abandon me. Forsake me not, my God of deliverance. Though my father and my mother leave me, the Lord will care for me. Teach me your way, O God. Guide me on the right path to confound my oppressors. Abandon me not to the will of my foes. False witnesses have risen against me, people who breathe out lies. Mine is the faith that I surely shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in the Lord and be strong. Take courage, hope in the Lord. Lule hamanti lerot betu vadonai, lerot betu vadonai be'eretz chayim. Lule hamanti lerot betu vadonai, lerot betu vadonai Be'eretz Chaim. You now turn to the Mourner's Kaddish, and I invite you to bring into your heart all those you have loved and lost, anyone for whom you are in mourning, if you are observing a Yahrzeit, or if it is your custom to say the Mourner's Kaddish. Yitgadal v'yitkadash Shemei Rabbah, v'alma divra kirutei v'yamlich malchutei, v'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'chaye dechol Beit Yisrael, v'agala uv'izman kari v'imru amen, Yehe Shmei Rabbah mevorach le'olam ulome olmaya, Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitroman v'yitnasei, v'yithadar v'yitale v'yithalal Shmei dukudisha brichu, ואלה מן כל ברכתה ושירתה, תושבחתה ונחמתה, דאמירן בעולמה ואמרו אמן. יהי שלמה רבה מן שמיה, וחיים עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן. עושה שלום במרומיו, הוא יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל ישראל ואמרו אמן. May the one who ordains peace in the universe bring peace to us, to all Israel, and to all who dwell on earth, and let us say amen. I want to wish you all a Shabbat Shalom, a Shabbat of peace and love, happiness, friendship, and health. And I look forward to celebrating Shabbat again with you next week.